¿Cómo se llama?
Jack in the Box, uh-huh. Muy buenas, por like cierto. It? Yesterday me comí una muy riquísima, ¿sí? Un 10.
Okay.
In and Out, muy buenas, pero tengo años. Desde que me salí embarazada de mi hijo José, me comí una hamburguesa, un antojísimo, y me la comí. Muy buenas.
¿Te gusta?
Sí, a la
¿cómo se llama?
10.
Okay.
10. ¿Cómo Popeyes? Se llama? No me acuerdo haber comido Popeyes nunca. Dice la Emily que sí una vez, pero no remember. Sorry, guys. No puedo dar puntos.
Okay.
¿Qué es eso?
¿Qué dice?
Windows. Muy ¿cómo? Caras y muy malas. ¡Zero! ¡Zero! ¡Asco!
¿No te gusta? ¿Cómo se llama?
No me gustan las Win.
¿No?
¿Qué es eso? Canes.
Ajá, Canes.
Canes, nunca he ido yo ahí, ¿no? Emily, Canes.
Raising King.
No, no conozco ese lugar. Sorry, Emily, no te ¿no? puedo dar punto. Okay. Sorry.
All right, affirmations with Scarlett while we do her hair. I am brave.
Mommy, you spit on me. You spit on me.
Oh, I'm sorry. Okay. I am brave.
I'm brave.
I am strong.
I'm strong.
I am kind.
I'm kind.
My friends love me.
My friends love me.
I am confident.
I'm confident.
Yes. And I got sass.
I'm sad.
Yeah. I'm beautiful.
I'm beautiful.
You know what? I love my curls.
Mommy, you're so beautiful, Mommy.
Oh, thank you, baby. Thank you. You're beautiful.
Yeah, you're beautiful.
You're beautiful.
You're beautiful.
And I love my curls.
I love my curls. Have a good day.
Who is it?
Hi! Hi. Mom, I miss you.
Hello!
So
I miss you.
My life be like. Ooh, yeah. Ooh. My life be like. Yeah.
¿Quieres ir a McDonald's? ¿Te puedo comprar chicken nugget? Nah, hija, mejor vamos a Walmart. No, mejor a Home Depot. No, pero el AT&T no sirve para nada. Hey, hija, pásame un strawberry.
Siempre es la misma situación cuando paso por mi chava para salir a pasear.
I'm getting tired and I need somewhere to begin. If you have a minute, why don't we go? Talk about it somewhere only we know. This could be the end of everything. So why don't we go?
So from elementary all the way up to like 7th grade, I was one of the darkest kids in class. And when I tell you kids used to bully me, and it wasn't just little joking that little kids do. Like they would literally come up to me and be like, hey, you burn black bastard. And I would just be like, where is all this hate coming from? And then I would go home and look at these beautiful women and fine men like Lupita and Chadwick Boseman and be like, what is there to hate?
Amá, ¿cómo se llama esa tienda?
Lois, la Lois, wow, muy like buena it? Tienda y like it, aunque okay. Nunca compré.
Okay. ¿Y esta tienda cómo
ay,
se llama?
Esa verga está bien, complice. Beta, ¿cómo? Bathroom, bello, no como, uh-huh. Bello, no como.
Uh-huh. Good job.
No me gusta, está muy caro todo, no sí. Me gusta.
¿Esta tienda cómo se llama?
Wow, TG Maxx, tengo tarjeta de TG Maxx, me encanta la ropa y me compro casi toda mi ropa en Lois, en la Lois.
TG Maxx.
TG Maxx, I like.
¿Esta tienda cómo se llama?
Kohl's, no me gusta. ¿No me gusta? Está muy bonita la ropa, pero está carísimo. Yo no me compro ropa cara porque no ocupo comprarme ropa cara. Pura ropa de 99 cents.
¿Esta tienda
Target,
cómo se llama?
I like it, Target. Muy buena tienda. Encuentras de todo, de muy buena calidad. I love Target. Lo es como chingo con la Lowe's. I guess I'm dressed to play date to you.
You're so beautiful.
Beautiful mommy.
You're my best friend.
My best friend.
Thank you.
Beautiful whole world, mommy.
The whole wide world?
Yeah.
You're beautiful in the whole wide world.
You're beautiful world. Whole wide world. Mommy, I love you so much.
Baby, I love you so much.
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 You my girl.
You my girl.
You my girl.
You my girl.
Your parents are strangers, technically. What I'm saying is completely wrong, but just go with it. You've got a random 40-year-old that you live with, and you call them mom. It just so happens that that person is the reason you're alive. If this person was your manager at work or even your teacher, you might hate this person's guts by the way that they think, by the way that they act or treat you. But since they're your parents, you're almost conditioned to love them no matter what. As you get older, you'll be able to see your parents' true colors, whether they're a racist, a narcissist, or just a downright terrible human being. The best thing about being an adult is that you don't have to fuck with your parents anymore. It's like, if they treated you bad and you just don't like them, like, you can kind of push them to the side. Yes, they raised you and you can thank them for that, but that was kind of their job. Basically, the entire idea I'm trying to get at is that parents still have to earn your respect and they have to be someone that you feel like you can vibe with. At the end of the day, they're human beings too, and you can choose whether or not you want to be associated with them.
My child will never have to sneak into the kitchen at 2 o'clock in the morning talking about they're hungry. Because if I walk in there and I see them, I'm going to be like, who driving, me or you? Because we finna go to this McDonald's at the end of the day. Let's go.
I think the disconnect when it comes to cultural appropriation, especially dealing with Black American culture, is that people don't understand what it means to us. Black Americans had a culture. They had a heritage. They were completely stripped of that culture. The little remnants left of what we have a connect to with Africa, we took that, made our own culture, and that's what Black American culture is. And that culture in itself, we get called ratchet for it, ghetto for it. We wear, we get kicked out of schools. We wear, we lose jobs. We get demeaned for it. And then to turn around and see someone who is white or of lighter color wearing that exact same culture and get called fashion. It's the new trend. You call it boxer braids and stuff and give everyone else credit for what we do, what we made, and what we still get belittled and demeaned for. That's where we draw the line. And that's why we're like, no, no one can wear it. Because we can't even wear it yet. It's our own culture that we had to make. We were forced to make because our actual culture was taken from slavery. So the culture we had to make, this is our second culture, is getting taken from us while we still don't have it. That's the problem.
Seeing this comment on my video, and I liked it, and I didn't even fully read it because I was liking all the comments because I wanted people to know that I do see you guys. I do pay attention to who's watching my videos, but seeing this comment breaks my heart. I have a 12-year-old sister and a 1-year-old brother who look just like me, and they're Black. And seeing this comment on a video about racism? Are you kidding me? How can people even be against the Black Lives Matter movement? I don't get it. I genuinely don't understand. Like, these are children. We have to do better.
Okay, I'm bored in a house and I'm in a house bored. Bored in a house and I'm in a house bored. Bored in a I was bored and I'm bored and I'm bored and I was bored.
Amá, ¿cómo se llama esa tienda?
Ay, qué jodida me veo. Walmart, guau, wow, mi tienda favorita, Walmart. Uy, es que viejita me...
¿Y esta tienda cómo se llama?
De Home Depot. De Home Depot. Oh, I like it, Home Depot. Home Depot.
¿Y esta tienda?
La Walgreens. I like it, Walgreens. Siempre voy a agarrar mis recetas de mi medicina, Walgreens.
Walgreens, ok. ¿Y esta tienda cómo se llama?
Ay, Costco. Soy miembro de Costco. No salgo de Costco. I like it, Costco.
Ay, nunca más, mentirosa.
¿Cómo no, pendeja? Pues de vez en cuando no voy seguido porque venden cosas de mucho y no me gusta.
¿La Costco?
Costco,
okay. ¿Y esta tienda cómo
se llama? ¡Wow! Burlington. La neta, Burlington. I like it. Me encanta. Ahí me compro mis office. Mis office. Ahí me los
outfits.
Compro. Mis office. Ahí me los compro.
Outfits.
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 Office.
Ay, Amaya.
Ah, que Meli, shut up.
Do not mess with these Hispanic parents. Because, bro, I was watching a video on Instagram. This Hispanic mom told her daughter to come here because she found out she had a boyfriend or something like that. And the girl said no. The mama asked her again. She said, come here. She said no again. So the mama was like, oh, okay. Then the girl started running. And then out of nowhere, the mom was like, oh, so you, okay. Oh, this is a chancla. I will bust you in your head right now.
I don't want to be that person, but my brother and I just discovered something about the reopening of Walt Disney World. Out of all the Disney princesses that could come back, only two did not make the cut. And the two that they choose. They pick the one from the Pacific and China. I know what you're thinking, Monica. Moana is not Asian. I know that, but as a former performer, I also know that most, if not all, of her friends are of Asian descent. Don't ask me how I know that. And honestly, I think Disney just did it because they knew that they would have racist guests that would provoke derogatory discrimination against their Asian performers, which is depressing. Have a magical day. Happy ever after
Disney. I wish you be.
So a lot of people are apparently confused about why we don't like being called the blacks, and some people are even trying to like turn it on its head and say the blacks and then something positive. No, still don't call us the blacks. We still don't want to be called the blacks. It's dehumanizing. We are people. Black people. Black community. African American. Whatever. Just not the blacks. We're not the blacks. We're people.
I still think it's crazy that people used to start fights at 8 a.m. in school, bro. School used to force us to eat pizza with chocolate milk, then do damn pacer tests and 5-on-5 basketball games, then go back to class sweaty as hell. High school was assimilation, and you can't tell me that was real. You can't. It's frizz in the bottle, it's Nikki, full throttle, it's oh. Swimming in the grotto, we winning in the lotto, we dipping in the pot of blue flow. So, shit is so good, it's dripping, I don't would get a ride in that engine that could go. Batman robbing it, bang bang cocking it, Queen Nikki dominant, prominent, it's me, Jesse and R.
Hi everyone, I'm going to tell you guys about a girl by the name of Juliana, and she has severe neuromuscular disorder, and when it came down to her final hours, she chose heaven over the hospital. She had gone through so much pain with this, and all she wanted was to be better. Her mom even asked her, do you want to go to the hospital, or do you want to go home? And she said she just wanted to go home, even though she wouldn't be with her parents, because that would mean if she goes home, that she would die and go to heaven. So now she's looking over us and she's in a better place and she's healed. So rest in peace, Juliana. You're in a better place. I've been blue so many times.
Shout out to Mr. Watsky, my fifth grade elementary teacher who taught me all about Jewish history and Jewish culture, as well as finding a way to convince my elementary school that taking a whole bunch of mostly Christian and Catholic kids to a synagogue was a good idea. Because it was. It was great cultural exposure.
So you guys like hearing a lot of the bad stories that come out of the Disney store, but there's a lot more good ones, and it's the reason we love working there and why we stay for so long. One of the first times I worked in one of these types of stores, they're called Imagination Park stores. They're meant to give people that Disney magic from the parks in their hometown. I was at the front demonstrating some Cars 3 toys, and this little boy came in with his parents. He wanted to race with Lightning McQueen, so I gave him the controller. We raced up and down the pixie dust path, and he had a fun time. And then before he left, the dad was like, okay, give the lightning back to Sergio. And the little boy came up to me and was like, thank you, Sergio. And I was like, you're welcome, bud. Come back and play with lightning anytime. So the little boy took off with his mom, and the dad stopped me and was like, I just want you to know this was a big moment. He's actually autistic, and he's never spoken to anybody besides us before. And I just wanted to say thank you. And that moment sticks with me. If I remember having a bad day, I just think about that magical moment.